Jæja, það skoður okkur hún. Clowners game, listen to this playoff game. Good, good, good. Slam, hi.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. Here in the divisional round, the pressure gets dialed up several more notches. Some players rise to the occasion. Some can't handle the heat. We'll see who shines in the spotlight and gets his team to the conference title game. It's the Jaguars going up against the Titans.
All right, thank you, Larry. We are across the Cumberland River from downtown Nashville at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee.
Up.
They go play action here on first down. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on his first drive. Instead, second down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw to Decker over the middle, and he gets it down to the 32. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Well, I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's 3 catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. 3 catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Again, it's Murray. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive, and normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let them down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff them for a loss. They'll look to throw here. It's caught, Decker. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Hey, Martus. Okay. No, that's my boyfriend.
Off the play fake. He'll look to throw. And he's got it. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Rashard Matthews from 21 yards away. And the Titans have taken a first quarter lead. A long way to go in this one. I'm sure that's not the only score we'll see today, but to jump out like that, very good.
Yeah, everyone wants to set the pace. You know, in a game like this, you want people chasing you.
Yeah, fair enough.
Here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they...
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back, but it will be a loss on the play. A near turnover, but the offense recovers it. Now they'll try to regroup on second. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And they'll get him to the ground, but he got all the way down to the 30-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart, because they'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or also just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Second down following the run.
Oh!
And it's incomplete. Rashard Matthews, the intended target, and it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here.
Yeah.
An ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just try
to. Well, they can believe it. Come on.
He'll look to throw. They locate Walker complete. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop him?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness.
With the former Volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Titans with a football here to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. Second and goal after the gain of five.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Watch They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete here. Matthews, the intended target, and it's third and short.
Had a great idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
The offense on third down, a perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. They're looking at a third and goal here. He'll drop to throw, and this will be caught. It's Matthews for the Tennessee touchdown. Rashard Matthews, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Now right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Hoping now to get back in the end zone on this fourth possession. And Murray's still down. Maybe shaking up that go around. Let's hope he's all right. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Henry. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
He is
a big, not just a big man,
big,
a huge man.
Big, big boy.
Well, how about the credit then for the defense to be...
Whoa, happy man. Fuck yeah, happy man. Yeah, but golden.
It took four of you to take a guy like that down, right?
Well, that's for sure. And you know what, else?
Oh.
I didn't want to challenge him at dinner either. A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
A first down carry for Henry. And a good stiff arm there before he's brought down on a nice little game. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Now again, first man through. This is Fowler. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play, and that's going to lead them to fourth down. Throw here out of the gun. They find some open field here. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. To play here in the first half. Back with more AFC playoff action after this timeout. A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Larry Ridley at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. Derrick Henry, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. They'll run it again with Henry. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Back to throw here. And complete to the tight end Walker, right side. Calling a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. If there was one area that the coach emphasized in our pregame meeting, it was red zone offense.
Yeah.
The sense I got from it, and I think you did as well, they weren't real happy with how they were executing previously, so they put a lot of time and effort into it, because getting points is paramount. Doesn't matter what you do otherwise, don't leave the red zone without putting points on the board.
The intended receiver there was Jonnu Smith, and that'll bring up second down.
Yep.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on.
Go Boston. Put your slight hop there and Smith pull it again.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Delaney Walker from 13 yards out. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs.
Yep.
And the Titans getting set to go. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it. Because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
So it's on to halftime in this AFC divisional round matchup, as we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports halftime report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA halftime report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Titans are happy to be in front right now and just want to play 2 more solid quarters. The Jaguars just want to come out after the half and claw their way back into the game. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. 1st and 10, Matthews gonna haul in the pass over the middle, and he kept off the long drive with a touchdown. Titans with the early advantage. Hits till late in the first. Decker is by himself here, and he'll end up at the 30-yard line before being tackled. Sticking with the same drive, pass will be completed over the middle, and it leads to a touchdown as they move out in front 14-0. Titans with the ball late in the half. Walker's got the catch over the middle, and he goes in for 6 as they go up here at 21-0. So that's going to do it for us.
Ball game. Good.
Second half begins with a run by Henry. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
Yards to go here on second down. Again, it's Henry. And they're able to get this one across the 35. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Tenth carry now for Derrick Henry. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Here we go with second and 7.
Whoa!
Derrick Henry all alone.
Woo!
Derrick Henry, 59 yards. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been
at the point. Game over! Game over! Yeah, he'll be ball.
Of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Yeah, but I'll skip him with them again.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. They begin with Henry. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go to a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
This was boxing. You think maybe they would have thought about stopping this one, because this defense has been bruised, it's been battered. But this is why they keep the fight going, right? They just got done with a really nice play, showing they still got a little bit left, don't they?
Haven't had many plays that they can clip, put in the film room, and smile about, but hey, there's one.
Clip and save.
On second down, here's Henry. Break one tackle, but then quickly brought down, but a nice little gain. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that is going to set up a third and one.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
The Titans on third down. They've been excellent, 6 for 7. They're up against a third and one situation. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he'll go down, and that will do it. Through the third quarter of action. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Nashville. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They'll drop the throw, and Walker has it. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? 3-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Now a handoff to Henry, and he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
One
blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open.
One, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and it'll be second and 12. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Alla sama. Lego pro one. Bar. Pull again.
They'll toss it to Henry. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long. The Titans on third down. Can't fault these numbers. 7 for 9 thus far. This is third down and 12.
Hey, hey, hey. Here we go now.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And able to find Decker. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That goes as a gain of 36 on third down. This is foul on the fullback. And he's not even able to get back to the line of scrimmage. Now there's also a flag down, and it's in
holding.
The area of holding.
Oh, okay. Holding. Oh, my God. Offense. Ten penny. Fuck me life.
So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide, and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
Here we go.
Looking to throw. Flush to his right. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charlie, are you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Yeah, okay.
They'll set up to throw. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack.
Oh, he played his
second. Campbell in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. He is racking the sacks up. Charles, 5 last week, now 2 here.
I don't care what they've done in scheme, it's not working. I mean, you can do it all day long, all night long. They did it all week, and it hasn't worked. And in fact, on that last sack, I thought I saw him drop a Pro Bowl ballot at the feet of the quarterback and say, here's a pen right in my name.
He keeps playing like this, he'll be dropping those ballots from a plane above the city. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard,
right,
they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth.
I don't know, I think so. And then we're sparking from my pizza. Oh, hello, hello. Oh, can I pull? Nada. Close it. No.
So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. Henry, and they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
Oh.
Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
Ik zie lepra's, maar zware lepen vlochten. Ik heb hem daar nog zwakke lepen om. En beter lepen heen, hem niet lichter lepen.
So that's a wrap for Charles
Davis,
I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Titans are winners here as we say so long from Nashville.